In a world where potatoes are worth more than gold, pufferfish can kill dragons, and Christmas is about fighting lava monsters, one question remains. Is my Minecraft girlfriend real, or am I being scammed? Take control of your own island to build, create wonderful landscapes, and construct monuments, then spend all of your time on the same island as everyone else, chopping trees and PvPers off, like a pacifist's Hunger Games where the only prize is carpal tunnel. Choose your class: Archer, Mage, Forum Arguer, Potato Fanatic, Scammer. Sorry, I was sick for the photo shoot. So gather your friends and partake in this MMORPG experience. Gather your fake online friends and grind skills past 3 a.m. Gather your amiibo collection and chop wood for 15 hours until you hear a noise that hits all the pleasure centers. Spend hours watching Technoblade farm millions of potatoes, then go on your own profile and get farming 13. Like watching MasterChef, then cooking yourself a cheese sandwich. Or criticizing red carpet attire, then going out in a hoodie and sweatpants. Or discussing John Petrucci's use of harmonics, then playing Smoke on the Water. I have infinite analogies that just get more niche, don't challenge me. Begin by discovering every corner and collection in the game. Fight zombies, wolves, zealots, and eventually move up into the bosses. You'll see endgame players battling dragons and one day aspire to be like them. But you won't be, you'll never be as good as them. Unless you are dedicated. If you think you're ready to focus your life solely on this one game mode, in one server of one video game, sacrificing friendships, hobbies, and vitamin D, then maybe you have what it takes to become a Skyblock Sweat. A title looked up in awe by all of humanity, ultimate respect and admiration. Wait, can I get sued for ruining people's lives with that statement? Gamers don't have human rights. Cool. And if you ever somehow get bored by the main grind of the game, there are plenty of alternative gameplay mechanics to play around with. Play a Guitar Hero simulator that changes in difficulty based on how far away you live from America. Sit in the lobby and count how many people are auto-clicking. Jump around aimlessly with a grappling hook. It's estimated that 12% of players are doing this at any time. There's a table that has Snap and a memory game, so if you don't have a deck of cards, that's good. You can complain on the forums? Otherwise, spend hours to finally become one of the only players in existence to have max level skills. Then a week later, the admins increase the skill cap. So put back on your gamer headset, cancel your gym membership, and tell any relatives you remember the name of, you'll see them next decade, because it's time to farm pumpkins. Some people may say chopping digital crops isn't a smart career move or mentally unhealthy, but remember, some people also think tonic water is good. You can't trust them. Either way, it's not long until Minecraft will be considered a therapy animal that helps people deal with stress, so may as well start now. For legal reasons, I'll finish off by saying it's a fun game, just don't get addicted. For my own enjoyment, I'll finish off by saying I'd rather do crack rock than play Skyblock.